Welcome to today's video and thank you for joining me on this episode. Today I'm going to be talking about a very crucial topic. What does your cervical mucus tell you about being fertile? So I'll be covering cervical mucus, its role in menstrual cycle, and how it can help you identify your most fertile days. Alright, cervical mucus is a fluid that is produced by the cervix, the uterus. It plays a crucial role in the reproductive process. Throughout the menstrual cycle, the consistency, the color, and amount of cervical mucus change, which indicates different phases of fertility. All right, to understand how cervical mucus relates to fertility, we must first grasp the basics of menstrual cycle. Now, the menstrual cycle consists of different phases, which include the menstruation phase. We have the follicular phase, the ovulation phase, the luteal phase. The hormonal changes during these phases influence the quality and quantity of cervical mucus. All right, so there are different types of cervical mucus. Each type of cervical mucus indicates a specific phase in the menstrual cycle. Now, let's explore these different types of cells. So, during the early follicular phase, the cervix produces minimal mucus or sticky mucus, which is not conducive to sperm survival. So, it indicates a very low chance of fertility. Alright, so obviously when you have like a very dry mucus, this is not a time of being, it's not indicating you're fertile. Type of cervical mucus is a creamy mucus starts to come out as the follicular phase progresses. The cervix starts to produce more creamy or lotion-like mucus, and it allows the sperm to be able to move easily and indicates the approach of ovulation. Now, the third type of mucus I'll talk about is the egg white. So the egg white mucus, this looks like, you'll see, you know the egg white, that's the white part of the egg, not the yellow part. We have two parts in eggs, right? That's the raw egg. So the egg white mucus, when you see something like an egg white mucus, around that time of ovulation, the cervix produce fertile quality mucus, which resembles raw egg whites, okay? This type of mucus is stretchy and it's clear and slippery, and are providing an ideal environment for sperm survival and mobility. So when you see that egg white mucus, just know that yes, this is the best time, or this really shows like I'm ovulating, or this I'm on my peak of fertile period. Okay, so this egg white mucus is a type of mucus, is stretchy, it's clear and slippery, it provides an ideal environment for sperm and survival mobility. The fourth type of cervical mucus I'm going to talk about is the post-ovulation mucus. So the post-ovulation mucus, this occurs after ovulation. The cervical mucus transitions back to a drier, stickier consistency. Yeah, because it's no more stretchy, it's no more like it's no more clear, it's no more slippery. Now it's now the post-ovulation mucus, it's now dry, it's very very sticky, not very like, not watery sticky, not like dry one. It indicates the end of the fertile window. So let's explore how you can use it to identify your most fertile days. All right. By monitoring changes in cervical mucus, you can predict ovulation and determine your fertile window. The appearance and texture of the cervical mucus can help you pinpoint the best time for intercourse to maximize the chances of conception. So the best time for intercourse, I'm going to say, is when you start to see egg white mucus. Egg white mucus, that shows you are in your fertile days, because that is the most conducive environment. It produces an ideal environment for the sperm survival and mobility. This is how you can monitor your mucus, and observing the changes throughout your menstrual cycle, you can identify your most fertile days, and this can increase your chances of conceiving. All right, remember to pay attention to the consistency, to the color and amount of your cervical mucus. Yes, the amount of your cervical mucus also, you need to Note that. All right, keep track of these changes to actually predict ovulation, and you can use that to plan conception when you can. All right, okay, thank you for watching this video on what your cervical mucus can tell you about being fertile. I'm wishing you success in your journey, and all you're trying to conceive, try to track. You can track your most fertile period using the cervical mucus tracking method. If you have any question, don't forget to drop it in the comment section. I'll be answering questions as much as I can. And if you have any other further question or anything, you can also seek professional advice. Consult your doctor, go to the hospital. And I'm going to be doing more videos on cervical mucus, and because some people have asked me different questions on that, I'm going to be starting with this. Probably in subsequent videos, I'm going to be talking about more information on cervical mucus, or if this is a normal amount, the quantity you're supposed to have, and all that. All right, thank you for joining me in this video. I'm going to be posting my next video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. My name is Ruth. I blog on nothing else, fitness and lifestyle. And don't forget to tap the notification bell, like that bell, tap it so that when I post new videos, we can always chat and we can always talk about new things. I am very, very passionate about health. I'm a nurse, I'm practicing in the United Kingdom, and I'm very, very passionate about health. All right. Don't forget to subscribe, share this video to your loved one, click on the subscribe button, click on the bell, and I'll be seeing you in my next video. I love you. Bye.